Welcome back, and in this part of the course, I want to step through how we create Docker images. Now, this means becoming familiar with Docker files and their syntax. I'll be covering the theory now, and then you'll get the chance to experience this practically when you create your own Docker image. So let's get started. So far in the course, you've had some practical experience in taking a Docker image on a public registry, for example Docker Hub, and downloading or pulling this to your local Docker host. Then, either as part of the same command or an extra step, you've run this image to launch a container. Now, this is a Docker file. Docker files contain a set of steps, instructions, or directives which are used via the Docker build command to create a Docker image. And just as with a Docker image that you pull down to your local Docker host, this can also be used to run a container. And in this part of the course, you're going to learn the theory of Docker files, as well as gain some practical experience of creating them and using them to make Docker images. Now, before you actually get to work and do this, you need to understand what it is that you're doing. So let's cover the structure and functionality of Docker files. Now, we're going to have a few bullet points here. Sorry in advance, I want to get through this part as quickly as I can and move on to where you'll be creating a Docker image. So let's just power through these as efficiently as possible. Now, I want to explain each of the elements that you'll commonly find within a Docker file. The structure is that comments start with a hash or a pound symbol, and then you have lines, and each of these lines has an instruction and arguments. Now, it's convention to have instructions in all caps to distinguish them from arguments. So these are the instructions that you'll generally find within a Docker file. First, we've got from, and this from instruction configures what base image is used as the foundation for the image that you're going to create. An example is Alpine, which is a lightweight Linux distribution ideal for Docker usage. It's only 5 MB in size, so it's perfect for efficient Docker images. Now, you can specify an image name and a version tag, for example, alpine:latest, and Docker files must have a from instruction contained within them. Next, we've got label, and this can be used to add metadata to an image, so things such as descriptions or who maintains the image. Next, we have some instructions which all create new layers in your Docker image. So each of the next three instructions will create a new layer, one layer per instruction. And I'm stressing this because I like to keep my Docker images as efficient as possible. And there are ways to minimize the number of layers, but that's a more advanced topic. For now, just be aware that each of these instructions creates a new layer. First, we have run, and run executes commands within a new layer of the image, and this is typically used to install packages, applications, test suites, or to perform other configuration. Any output of this run instruction will be stored on a new layer within the Docker image. Now, next, we have two instructions which do almost the same thing. We have copy and we have add. Now, what's common between them both is that they can take new files from a source location and copy them to a destination location within a Docker image, specifically a new layer in that image. Now, these are typically used to copy applications or application files from wherever you're running the Docker build command, and these files are copied into the image. The functionality gained using add versus copy is that add can add things from remote URLs and do some forms of extraction. Otherwise, they both do the same thing. They add files to a new layer within your image. Now, don't worry if this seems complex or confusing. I promise you it's not, and you're going to get practical experience of working with this very soon. Let's move on. Now, these next three instructions aren't about what is on the image. Instead, they relate to what the image does and how it's run. The first instruction is the command or CMD instruction. Now, this defines the default executable of a container. So if you create a container, you can state using CMD that you want it to run a certain web server or game server. When you run a container from an image, if you don't specify any arguments on the command line, then this default is chosen and used, but it can be overridden if you use CMD. Now, entry point does much the same thing as CMD, only it can't be overridden in the same way. So as a general rule, you would use CMD when you're creating a more general purpose container image, where you might want to allow different executables to be run within the container, whereas you would use entry point when you're creating a very specific single purpose container image. Otherwise, they're very similar, and they can be used together with CMD providing default options for the executable specified in the entry point instruction. Now, lastly, we have expose, and this informs Docker what port your container app is running on. So if you have a web app running via a web server on port TCP 80, then that app would be running in the container on that port. And expose is a way of telling Docker or whoever is running the container what port that application is running on. Now, it's important to remember this instruction does not perform any network configuration. It just informs Docker and anyone using it what port a containerized application is running on inside the container. Okay, so that's the basic theory and structure of Docker files. Elsewhere, I'll go into more detail, likely within my more in-depth Docker courses. For now, though, this is all the theory that you need to know. What I think will help is for you to get some practical experience in working with Docker files, and that's coming up next. At this point, that's everything I wanted to cover. When you're ready, go ahead and move on to the next part of the course where you'll actually work with Docker files and Docker build to build a container image.